os temporale is paired bone of the cranial division. It consists of three parts. The first part is pars squamosa. This is typical membranous bone. The second part is pars petrosa. Petras means stone, so it is very hard division of our skull. Pars petrosa. And the third part is pars tympanica. Pars squamosa. It forms the lateral wall of the skull. Look at its cerebral surface. Here you can see impressionis digitata, prints of gyruses of the brain. Processus zygomaticus starts from the outer surface of the squama. It connects anteriorly with the zygomatic bone. Its base has wide depression, fossa mandibularis, for articulation with the mandibular head to form temporomandibular joint. Fissura tympana squamosa is in the depth of the mandibular fossa. It divides into two, fissura petra squamosa anteriorly and fissura petra tympanica behind. Fossa mandibularis is bounded anteriorly by tuberculum articulare. It prevents the dislocation of mandible when we open the mandible very wide. Look at the pars tympanica. It forms anterior, inferior and partly posterior part of external acoustic meatus. This is meatus acousticus externus. It is part of the external ear which leads into the tympanic cavity. Its upper edge is called porus acousticus externus. Pars petrosa or pyramid. It has three surfaces. Faces anterior, faces forward, faces posterior, faces backward, and faces inferior, rough lower surface. And there are three borders between them, margo anterior, margo superior, and margo posterior. Look at the anterior surface. Impressio trigemini is near its apex. It is lodges for the trigeminal ganglion. There are two grooves on the surface. Sulcus nervi petrosi majoris passes medially, and sulcus nervi petrosi minoris is laterally closer to the squama. They lead to the openings of the same name, medially to the hiatus canalis nervi petrosi majoris and lateral hiatus canalis nervi petrosi minoris. Eminentia arcuata is seen on the base of the anterior surface of the pyramid. Roof of the tympanic cavity is between squama and eminentia arcuata. It is called tegmen tympani. Look at the posterior surface. The large opening of this surface has porus acousticus internus, which leads into the meatus acousticus internus. Upper border of pyramid separating anterior and posterior surfaces carries sulcus sinus petrosi superioris, accommodates the venous sinus. Posterior border carries half of the sulcus sinus petrosi inferioris, this one, which, together with the similar groove of the occipital bone, forms complete groove. This wide groove is sulcus sinus sigmoide. Look at the rough inferior surface of the pyramid. This is long and sharp process is called processus tiloides. It serves for attachment of the muscles. Foramen stylomastoideum is between styloid process and processus mastoideus. Medially from the styloid process is smooth fossa, fossa jugularis. Just anteriorly is foramen caroticum externum. This is outer opening of the carotid canal. Processus mastoideus is massive process. On the medial side of the process is deep incisura mastoidea. This one. Medial to this is a shallow fura, sulcus arteria occipitalis, for the occipital artery.